Talk to us about what it's been like to return to office again.
I felt quite comfortable coming in on the first day into the office because the dynamics are still the same. So it was like, just like going back to an old car, an old bicycle that you have driven before or ridden before. The people are new and younger, and I feel older than I really am, because when I came here, most of the people I worked with were older or same age and a few younger. Now, all of them are younger than I am. So possible generational difficulties and views, but I have not encountered any in the 1 month since I came into the office.
How concerned were you with the closeness of, you know, the election of the PM following the 14th of December last year, with the results coming in? There was, a bit of a wait for the people to find out who will lead the country, but a very close one as well, as you mentioned.
Yes, it was close, and we do not know whether those were the gospel truth accurate figures. So we had our own parallel system going, and they're still working, they're still counting to see if the figures that came out as a result are the figures that any other independent examiner would come up with.
And talk to us about how confident you are that you'll be able to work with your partners. You have the Soldelpa team as well as the NFP party. How confident are you that you'll be able to work as a coalition to lead Fiji?
I am very confident. I worked with the National Federation Party in 1999. And before that, when we were formulating the 1997 constitution, so we have worked together in the past. And so Soldelpa was the party that I helped to register. So I was confident at the beginning that we were still family. There might have been differences in the past, but we were still one family. It was only natural for us to come together and work together again.
And since you became Prime Minister, there's been some significant changes. There's been touted as the police commissioner level, as well as welcoming back those who were banned from returning to Fiji. Can you talk to us more about some of the changes that have happened since you took up the role of Prime Minister?
Well, those are one, the people returning to Fiji. It's interesting that many of those returning had thought that they were on a blacklist. When we asked immigration came out and there's no such thing as a blacklist of anybody being prohibited from coming back. When we cleared, they all came back and were very happy, but it also reflected the freedom in the atmosphere, in the air, when people feel free to do what they would like to do. People have come back and people are open and free to speak out against people in authority. And they have continued to speak out against me, but that is part of a daily routine for me. I duck a few shots and throw a few new ones. So it is part of being in a high profile position.
Prime Minister, I'd also like to talk to you about the military and the Fiji military. I understand that there's been military personnel returning to the barracks after the pseudo bodyguard role. Is that restoring confidence in the process of government and the role of the Fiji military?
It is a very soothing feeling to know when some people had feared that there were military personnel out on the streets, out in the public, and we probably didn't know who they were and what they were doing. There was a sense of fear and apprehension. So now that they have gone back, and the commander has given his assurances that they will stick by the law and act in accordance to the laws of Fiji. A lot of people are walking around with a renewed sense of security and freedom.
And what's the situation with the police commissioner? I understand that he was asked to step down from his role.
He was asked to step down when there were complaints leveled against him to allow for proper investigations to be carried out. Not step down, but step aside. He has decided not to and go through the normal processes of investigations to be carried out. The Constitutional Affairs Commission will be sitting later this week to consider those complaints to see if they warrant the setting up of a tribunal to consider the complaints.
And I understand the former Attorney General has just returned to Fiji and has been in question by local authorities. Are you aware of the nature of this and what have you been told?
Yes, he was allowed to go because there was nothing happening at the time he left. But since before his arrival, there had been some reports received. So he became a person of interest to be investigated by the police. The normal processes that I had been subjected to and all citizens must expect to be subjected to if there are issues against them from people, from members of the public. A member of the public would go to the police and make a report, and it's up to the police to carry out the investigation to see if there is any prima facie case, and they refer those to the proper authority for prosecution or whatever. Right now, he is a person of interest, but not yet subjected to court actions, any prosecution processes. So he is free to move around. But if it develops from there, then there might be some restrictions on his movements, particularly movements out of Fiji. And they will have to be checked for him to report to say that he is still here and until he gets to court, if he gets there.
And what is your relationship now in terms of, in the Parliament of Fiji with the former Prime Minister, Frank Bainimarama? Do you have constant talks with him as the leader of the opposition? So what's the communication like with you and the former Prime Minister?
There has been no communication outside of the Constitutional Affairs Commission. Something I had tried to encourage when I was in the opposition and as opposition leader for across the floor discussions on matters that affect the nation, and just continue to be friendly with one another, because we are friends. We grew up in the same profession, and now that we are older, we're both grandfathers, we should be having a different view about life and enjoy life more than spend your life hating other people.
Understandably, like the Pacific and different parts of the world, we are rebuilding after the impact of the global pandemic. What will be your priority, Prime Minister, in the next couple of months and then years going forward? And what are some of the challenges do you expect now that you're back in the Prime Ministership for Fiji?
I have had a briefing from my Minister for Health and asked him to stay abreast with the development or the degeneration of a health situation in the world, and make sure that we are right up there with the rest of the world in our countermeasures to be able to control or reduce the threat to the population of Fiji. In the meantime, we still have to upgrade our medical and health facilities and infrastructure, which will be a huge and mammoth task, because I believe a lot of the facilities we have would have been a lot better if we had kept up the periodic repairs and refurbishments and renovations that public facilities should have been subjected to over the years.
Given that the news that the new Prime Minister of New Zealand, Chris Hipkins, has been sworn in, and of course the first Pacific Deputy Prime Minister, Carmel Sepuloni, have been sworn in today. What are you looking forward to in terms of the relationship, you know, with this government going forward with your government of Fiji?
I do not see any potential for any changes. We have had excellent relationship with the government of New Zealand. And I just expect that to continue. I would like to congratulate Prime Minister Chris on his assuming that high position, and also congratulate and thank the outgoing Prime Minister, the past immediate past Prime Minister, for her role in the nation of New Zealand and in the region of the Pacific. She has been a very, very high performer in the 5 years that she had held the realm. And I'm sure her successor will do likewise. You know what I mean?